I'm fed. You've been out all night, know you've been bad. Don't tell me different, know it's a lie. Come to me, honey, see how I cry. Welcome to the Recovery Show with Bernie Z. That's me. Today I want to talk to you about the Unity program, step 9. And that's Addicts Anonymous. As such, ought never be organized. But we may create service boards or committees directly responsible for those who serve. And this fits right in nicely with the Unity Program 8, which is the non-professional and hiring special workers aspect of it. Because we're not going to be so organized that manipulation is used or anything like that. But we do have to be organized enough that we can come together and figure out, hey, something needs to be done, so let's set up a board or a committee to respond to those things. And as a result that those boards and committees, they aren't the be-all, end-all, but they are answerable to those in recovery who are not part of those boards. They're answerable to the entirety of the Unity program, to the Addicts Anonymous process, because that way, when a decision is made, it's brought to the general group, and they say, is this something that we see as something that can be good? And that's what leads to the potential employing of professional workers. That's the pace that involves writing down the guidelines that have been effective. That's the part that allows us to say, hey, look, we all have a say in it, and we all can be involved. But to formalize some of the groundwork, a group is put together to put it into words. And that's the hardest part of understanding that we're a group, we're a team, we're not individuals, we're not revolving around the power and control and manipulation of things. We're revolving around reaching out to others to help them come to recovery, but also reaching out to each other and working on recovery as a stronger unit. We can't do it alone, so we need some group unity. And that unity involves being able to do this kind of stuff, the committees and the boards and the idea of coming up with paths to work together towards it and be able to have a therapeutic environment. So I hope that this has helped understand a little bit of that, but I really would appreciate any input somebody has about what their thoughts are on the Unity program, step 9. And what they think that really means. Thank you.